It's incredibly exciting. Wow, it's just so unique. I just feel so lucky to be a part of it.
Captain does provide that mixture in terms of an equalness, in terms of how the whole city is composed. So that's really important being here.
We planned something quite different, quite unusual, immersing people in the experience of activist organizations, addressing a number of the key inequality issues in Cape Town.
Me coming to South Africa and having never been here before, adds a totally different dimension to this whole program.
One thing that perhaps people forget as academics and institutions is that our sensory bodies are just as important as our brains.
She says that you carry, you know, mountains on your shoulders because every space you sort of occupy in, there's a level of oppression.
Smelling smells, like stepping in the dirt and the rubbish that's strewn around, and seeing with your own eyes and touching the handles on those broken toilet doors, seeing the padlocks on those toilet doors, creates a visceral impact. It creates mental pathways that are very difficult to then unravel. And that directly impacts your future work. You always call back to that, you hearken back to that.
We can talk a lot about inequality, we can sit in classrooms and talk about Gini coefficients, but until you are on the ground in community and understand the impact of those numbers, it's sort of hard to feel the sense of urgency around it, and I think that our visit to Khayelitsha gave me that.
I really found it very interesting to see Africa placed at the forefront of the debates, because when you're teaching in London or you know, at a university in America or Europe, you're seeing things from a particular perspective. And to actually be in Africa and have lots of talks about making the African experience central gives you a different view of things.
Lots of amazing questions from the fellows. So they're really thinking very practically, pretty radically. The questions are coming from very different places, both geographically from different countries, but also from very different interests. You know, how do we work with different people? How do we understand this? So it's been great. One of the big issues is how people from very different backgrounds with very different interests learn to trust each other and respect each other. And I think this week in particular, we're starting to see that working very well.
Well, I think we're more used to each other now in terms of the level of comfort in sharing our views. That is the beauty of coming from different geographic perspectives, racial, class perspectives as well. It continues to reinforce the richness and the specialness of this program.
So just the whole experience of being in Cape Town, seeing Table Mountain, and it's been fantastic. Seeing the group gel and work together has been great.
They're amazing people, very special. They're on a mission, and that gives them a fire. You certainly learn as much from them as hopefully you give something back in return. We're moving forward together, equipping ourselves to do better in fighting inequalities.
We have shared values with the program. It's about inequality, it's about development, it's about Africa, it's about global relationships and partnerships. And all those things are things that we're trying to build. We're trying to build a network of progressive and effective reformers in Africa. And it's really, really useful for us to connect to this broader network.
I've taken a huge amount of hope already from this program, because the fellows are so committed to actually changing things.
I'm more optimistic than I was maybe a year ago, when I didn't have examples of what works, but now I do, and I think I'm finding coherence in that.